Hello and welcome to my channel SPARX STENOGRAPHER. Today I am going to deliver you a legal dictation. Exercise number 60, words 490, speed 100 words per minute. So guys, ready for the dictation. 10 second, 5 second, start. The question therefore that has to be answered in this petition is as to whether there was any valid payment after the award or deposit in accordance with the provisions of Section 31 of the Land Acquisition Act 1894, and secondly, whether the said payment did amount to a valid tender of the amount of compensation to the tenure holders or not. It has also to be seen as to whether this payment after 31 years would amount to a payment that would not attract the provisions of Section 24(2) of the 2013 Act. In order to attract the provisions of Section 24(2) of the 2013 Act, the fiction provided for therein of a deemed lapse has to be pressed into service, for which the necessary ingredient would be the existence of a fact which has to be contemplated in order to apply the fiction. Thus, the fact should be presumed to be in existence as on the date of the enforcement of the 2013 Act in order to invoke the fictional clause as contained in Section 24 of the 2013 Act. The question is as to whether what should be the date of payment of compensation in order to attract the aforesaid fiction. It is here that we find that the provisions of Section 24 of the 2013 Act require three conditions to be fulfilled, namely that the award should have been made 5 years or more prior to the enforcement of the Act. The aforesaid condition is fulfilled in the present case, and the possession was also taken. The payment has been made in 2011. On a plan reading of the aforesaid provisions, the fact of payment of compensation did exist as prior to 1st of January 2014. Thus, the existence of the said fact eliminates the possibility of invoking the fictional clause as contained in Section 24(2) of the 2013 Act, as the payment had been tendered prior to 1/1/2014. Consequently, if the payment of compensation has been made prior to 1/1/2014, the same cannot be said to be an invalid payment unless the payment which has been made falls short of the requisite payment to which the tenure holder was entitled. In our considered opinion, if the payment which has been tendered to the petitioners by way of checks, which is a literal payment as against the amount calculated under the award, is short of the amount which ought to have been paid of the petitioners under the award, then it that event the said payment cannot be said to be the full and complete payment as contemplated under the award. If that be the situation, then the petitioners can claim the benefit of Section 24(2) of the 2013 Act, provided there is an evidence to the effect that the payment made to the petitioners fall short of the payment to which the petitioners were entitled under the award. Stop.